previously, we've been working with Bulk Candy Store to lower their overhead and free up their team's limited time. Now, we need to reinvest those resources into new functionality that'll drive further growth. In this episode, we're going to add a subscription service to capitalize on Bulk Candy Store's loyal customer base. This is the e-commerce makeover. Bulk Candy Store has a loyal customer base, understandably so. Who doesn't like candy? Their focus on bulk buying and repackaging, along with nostalgia, gives them access to products that many other retailers can't get or don't carry. I think there's great opportunity to increase revenue with a well-designed subscription service. Let's sit down with Ken to discuss his thoughts about the potential for subscriptions and his ideas for what offerings to build.
How loyal are your customers?
Some of them are very, very loyal. There are particular products they want, and they come back month after month after month and buy those products over again. They are probably 20 to 30% of our business.
I think a subscription service is crucial for our business. I think the nature of our business is such that we should have been doing this years ago. Candy, popcorn, those are things that people just want over and over again. It'd be nice if I could just say to them, hey, I'm gonna give you 10% off, you just keep buying it. And of course they lock it in and keep going.
Those most loyal customers, have you observed any patterns with their buying?
They seem to have a pattern to, I buy a bag of these, it takes me this amount of time to eat them. I buy another bag because I know I'm going to be out in a day. If I look around, I see a lot of people offering popcorn of the month club or candy of the month club. And we have such a wide variety of items and flavors and colors. We're ideal for that. And I think that a lot of people would do that just for the excitement. I think it would be an instant revenue generator. And it's something we could do easily. I want to get that in here because I think it's an easy way to generate revenue. You put it up once and it keeps building up on its own.
Do you think offering them a discount to set up a more regular subscription would work for them?
100%. If they don't have to go in and place the order every month, if they know it's done, they'd be happy, because especially the ones that call in. We can say to them, hey, would you like to just have this order shipped to you once a month? Absolutely. I've had people ask for that, and I think it would just build our repeat business tremendously.
If the customers are asking for it, seems like an obvious thing to offer them.
Yes, it does. If we can get that functionality built in, that would be a game changer for us.
As far as subscription services, I think there are a couple different things I'd like. As I said, one of them is I'd like to offer individual products on a subscription basis, because there are certain people who love certain items. I also want to do a subscription service where we kind of surprise you. So you have a candy box of the month club where we're able to put different candies in and surprise you with different new things or old things. A popcorn of the month club where we give you two or three of our staples and maybe a new flavor every month.
What type of products are these most loyal customers buying?
A lot of them center around things actually that other people don't have. So for example, these little silver candies I have called coffee prims, or things that we do special. I think we were the first ones to actually take Tootsie Pops that come in a 39-pound case and separate them out into separate colors and sell them. The one that they put in least is orange. And so when people know we have orange, they want it. So if I had a thing where, if I knew that I had 17 customers who wanted a bag of orange every month, we could plan ahead. Like some of the other features we wanted, we didn't want to put subscription services in the last year or so because we knew that Magento was coming to its end of its life. And if it's coming to the end of its life, we have to put a lot of time and energy into building something that would just go away. We had to put it on the back burner for a while, but it's something that I think would really do well for us.
This subscription service has to be really simple, both for the customer and for the Bulk Candy Store team. The last thing we want to do is overwhelm them with customer support requests or more overhead that takes them away from the other things they need to be doing to run the business. Before we get into the right solution for this problem, if you want to learn more about how we're helping Bulk Candy Store, go to ecommercemakeover.com and download our free playbook on everything we're doing, including special offers on all the tools we'll be using, and of course, subscribe to be notified when we release new episodes. Although we're confident in the potential of the idea, this is a new initiative, so we don't really know how well it's going to perform. As a result, we need to keep the upfront investment low until we're sure that customers are going to respond to this offering. Now, that means finding a solution that integrates out of the box with BigCommerce and has pricing that is small business friendly. Recharge definitely fits that bill and was the perfect choice for Bulk Candy Store's needs.
Hi, my name is Lindy Cray. I'm VP of Partnerships at Recharge. Recharge powers subscriptions for all the products that you use every day in your own homes.
Hi, Ken.
Hi, it's Lindy. Great to meet you. Nice to meet you too.
What challenges are you facing with the business right now?
I think our biggest problem is re-engaging our customers. And there's an old saying, you can only increase your sales three ways. Get more customers, get them to buy more, get them to buy more often. We're trying to work with number two and three, especially since we picked up so many more customers during COVID.
Yeah, absolutely. And subscriptions is a great way to increase the lifetime value and the customer engagement of that loyal customer base, or even those early customers that have bought once and then increase their retention. And even, you know, once you've engaged them with a subscription, it's a great mechanism to increase their average order value, get them to try some of those other products.
Subscriptions is a great way for businesses to realize recurring revenue, but it's also a great way for them to reward their loyal customers and give their customers control over the products that they want to receive on a regular basis.
So I'm interested to hear a little bit about, I guess, your loyal following. What's the nature of how your customers buy?
I have certain people who buy the same product over and over again. A woman just yesterday called me to place an order, and I looked back at her history while I was here, and she's been ordering the same candy from us since 2014.
Oh, wow.
But everyone's an individual order.
Right. So she's basically a subscriber already herself,
yes.
Right? Managing it on her own. But there's probably opportunities to increase her average order value or expand the products that she's buying.
A business should be thinking about subscriptions if they have customers that come back time and time again to buy the same product. Offer those customers a subscribe and save on that product. They get the benefit of a discount and the benefit of having that product that they love show up right when they need it. The merchant has the benefit of knowing exactly what's coming in the next period, so they can forecast their inventories and buy appropriately for the coming period.
So with Recharge, we can actually put up individual products. We can just choose existing products, or do we make, like, I know a lot of people do subscription boxes, like a popcorn of the month or something.
Yeah, exactly. So there's a couple different solutions that sound like they would be right up your alley. One is subscribe and save. They can choose that subscription. They can choose the frequency that they want to receive it and the quantity. The other product or subscription type you might want to think about that you referred to is a subscription box.
That's great. That sounds like exactly what we want to do. We want to do it with chocolate and popcorn.
A candy store is a great example for a subscription model because people are very passionate about candy. People love candy and they have very strong opinions about what they like. And in addition to that, sometimes they're looking for something that's difficult to find. And when they find a source for that product, they want to make sure that they can get it on a regular basis, and subscriptions helps make sure it's never out of stock.
I assume you're using other technology in your technology stack. What else are you looking at using?
We'll be using Clevu for search, Klaviyo for our emails, Just Uno for pop-ups, Shipper HQ for shipping, and ShipStation to manage our shipping.
Recharge integrates directly with Klaviyo, and that allows Klaviyo to use data from your Recharge subscription to send automated emails, create personalized product recommendations, and deliver post-purchase engagement campaigns that, you know, can allow you to retarget cohorts, attract them back to the subscription model, or offer them upsells. We also integrate with Shipper HQ and ShipStation, so that way you know the customers can still leverage their preferred provider for their subscription.
Oh, great! So basically, I have a lot to learn.
Yeah, I mean, we're looking to add that additional value to your existing tech stack and make it as smooth as possible.
Sounds perfect.
For subscriptions, the most important thing is that you empower your customer. It's not about locking your customer in to something that they signed up for in the beginning. It's about giving them the flexibility to make changes and to cancel if they need to cancel. So give them a customer portal where they can log in, or give them options where they can communicate with you so that they can make changes to their payment method, to their address, to the product that they're receiving, how often they get it delivered, and even let them pause if they're gonna be out of town. They don't want their chocolate delivered when they're not there to take it inside and prevent it from melting.
If we can make subscriptions work for Bulk Candy Store, it has the potential to have a dramatic impact on the business. It can significantly increase the lifetime value of customers while providing stable cash flow. Let's get it set up so we can actually start seeing those benefits. We started by installing the app, connecting Braintree to Recharge to handle payments, and configuring Recharge for things like shipping and taxes. We then published the widget that appears on product pages, and it's all ready for Ken to start rolling out subscriptions. We've thrown a lot at Ken with this project, and it's only been live for a few weeks. It's doubtful he's had much time with a new initiative like subscriptions. At the end of the series, we'll check in to see how it's going, but I want to get Ken's early thoughts on the process and Recharge.
So what's your vision of where we can go with this subscription service?
I think the subscription service is going to be a huge boost to our business. It's something we've been talking about for years. I think that we can do just the products alone with people who are buying these same products. I think it'll be a big win. And I think that we have the ability to do a number of different of the month clubs or subscription clubs or what have you, like the popcorn of the month club, the candy of the month club. We can do the soda of the month club eventually, the drinks. I think we can really capture a lot of that in a way that a lot of people can't. I'm open to make it 10, 15% of our revenue at a minimum.
So tell me about the popcorn of the month, the first big one. What are we doing there?
First big one is gonna be the popcorn of the month club. What we're gonna do is have probably three what we call munch bags, which are about 5-cup bags. We're gonna have three of them in a kit. It'll be sold as a kit every month, every 3 months, every 6 months, whatever you want. You'll be able to buy it. We'll put in the chef special of the day plus two other popcorns. We're gonna do it including shipping. That way people don't have to worry about it. And we're gonna launch it this week, actually. We are looking forward to it, and I think it's gonna be a winner because I see other people have these and they're not doing it as well.
What is everyone else not doing?
I've looked through a lot of the other clubs out there and they just say, we're gonna give you a small bag or a large bag. They're not giving people information. What is the size of the bag? How much are you getting? Is it worth the money? Some of them are including shipping. Some of them aren't including shipping. Our goal is to be very, very clear with the customer what they're getting, and I think that'll drive a lot more sales.
How are we gonna market that? I mean, it's obviously not Field of Dreams. It's not just put it up there and people come buy it. What is the plan to actually get an uptake in those subscriptions?
The plan is twofold. For individual products that we're offering subscriptions on, what we're gonna do is start contacting the customers who buy those regularly. So for example, there's a product we carry called Coffee Prims. It's a little silver wrapped coffee candy. And we have a lot of people who buy that on a regular basis. So we've put it on as a subscription. You can do it every 30, 60, 90 days. And what we're gonna do is, I've discovered with Klaviyo, I can go in and narrow down and create a segment of people who bought Coffee Prims. For the popcorn, what we're probably gonna do is look at people who've bought, from our list, who've bought our gourmet samplers, right. People who've bought popcorn in the past. Plus, we're gonna put a big advertising splash on it and probably do some social media.
Recharge, you've only been working with it for a short time now, but how has it been working with the platform?
It's been working great. It's seamless. I can literally go in if I want to add, for example, these products right here. If I want to add these Tootsie Pops, I literally go in and I say, I want to add that product. What kind of discount do I want to give for it? And how often do I want to offer it as a subscription? And I'm done. So the integration is smooth and really, really easy. I thought it would be much harder than that, and I'm thankfully was wrong.
You doubted us.
Exactly. I guess. I doubted the process.
Coming from your history.
Yes.
Right? Things were much more complicated.
Yes, I thought it'd be much more complicated, but it really is. I could probably do the whole store in a few hours.
So we're going to talk in about a month, once we've had the site live for a while and you've been working with all of these tools, to get more of the results.
Okay.
What's our goal for subscriptions?
I'd like to see several hundred popcorn subscriptions at least in the next month and a half.
So several hundred in the next month and a half.
Mm-hmm.
That's lofty again. Like, we're keeping these lofty goals.
I would rather shoot high than say 25 and make 25. I'd rather say 100 and make 75.
Okay, we've got to work
better.
That out for
yep.
us then.
Exactly. Well, I'm not going to make it easy on you, TJ.
I don't ask you to.
I'm looking forward to celebrating those first subscriptions when we check in on the progress later in the series. In our next video that you can click here to watch, We're going to preemptively fix a problem that no business wants to have by setting up sales tax automations. Be sure to click over here to go to ecommercemakeover.com to download our free playbook on how we're growing bulk candy store and to receive special offers on the tools we'll be using. And don't forget to subscribe so that you'll be notified each time we release new episodes.